If you're like me, probably the greatest problem we have with consistency is consistency itself. It's very hard to be consistently consistent about everything. One of the areas that we sometimes struggle with, maybe even often struggle with, is our language, our tongue. That's what James is talking about in James chapter 3. The first several verses, extensive discussion about our language, our tongue, and how we use it, because the words that come out of our mouth indicate what's inside our heart, inside our mind, what's inside our thinking. And there's an illustration that kind of closes out the thoughts, actually a couple of illustrations from nature that close out the thoughts regarding this that I want to read, and then come back and read the verses just prior to that that drive home the real point about the inconsistencies we sometimes see in the words that we use. In James chapter 3, verse 11, he says, "Does a spring send forth fresh water and bitter from the same opening? Can a fig tree, my brethren, bear olives, or a grapevine bear figs? Thus, no spring yields both salt water and fresh." Pretty easy to understand and get a hold of those illustrations. But they're about the words that we use. They're about our tongue. When you back up a couple of verses, he says, "With it," the tongue, "with it we bless our God and Father, and with it we curse men who are made in the similitude of God. Out of the same mouth proceed blessings and cursings. My brethren, these things ought not to be so." You ever thought about that? We go to church on Sunday and we sing praises to God, holy, holy, holy. We pray to God and we speak of God in such a reverent and holy way. And then what happens on Monday? Well, there's a clerk at the store that's a little less than efficient. What do we say about that person? And then on Tuesday, there's an in-law that we had a disagreement with. What do we say about that person? And then on Wednesday, the utility worker steps on our flowers when he's reading the meter on our house. What do we say about that person? And on it goes until we loop back around to Sunday and we're saying, "Holy, holy, holy," once again. My brethren, these things ought not to be so. Instead, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. "Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but only that which is necessary for edification. Say all that we say and do all that we do," everything that comes out of our mouth, "let it impart grace to those who hear."